I'm recording this animation of the radar. It looks like there's a spiral over the mainland United States. It almost looks like the formation of a hurricane to me, which is strange to see that a formation of a hurricane over land instead of over the ocean. And it's huge. I'm going to zoom in a little bit more. Now, yesterday I was driving from Texas to Arkansas. I was driving from around the Dallas area to Arkansas, and I saw a wall of clouds, which it looked like a straight line at the time. My wife took these pictures of the clouds. You can see how unusual the length and straightness of the clouds are. Doesn't this kind of look like the beginning of a hurricane over the United States? It's got kind of a spiral shape to it. I see rings. And I used to believe that HAARP was controlling these rings. But I since read the Holy Bible and read that God's in control of the weather. And he's been in control of it ever since the world was created. He uses weather to serve judgment and to try to wake people up and to gain their respect, get people to realize that there's a higher power, that we people are not in control. As much as we like to think we control this planet, there is someone much more powerful than us. I also had a dream, and I made a video about it. I had a dream of flooding. This is the video that I recorded a few months ago about a very strange dream I had about flooding in the Detroit area between Lansing and Detroit. Never had quite a dream like that. I don't know for sure where the dream came from, but the dream seemed supernatural to me. I'm going to change to see the precipitation view. How about the satellite view? Actually see what the clouds look like. Wow, that sure does look like kind of like a hurricane to me. Or it's a spiral shape like a hurricane. Don't you think that these cloud shapes look unusual? I mean, have you ever seen anything like this? A spiral forming over the middle of the United States, not out in the ocean. It does look like might have been fed from the Gulf of Mexico. Perhaps moisture was coming up out of the ocean, going into the clouds. But this looks so unusual, and I wouldn't be surprised if there's some severe weather that results from this. I mean, something newsworthy. Well, I see a lot of these clouds are going over the Great Lakes. All of these green circles mean it's a strong cell. Yellow means possible damaging winds. All of the green areas mean that there's a flood warning. Lots of flooding in Arkansas, where I'm located, Texas. Many times I have heard prominent speakers blaming these weather problems on carbon dioxide, the gas that's essential for life, for all plant matter on Earth, the gas that we exhale with every breath. If you think there's any truth in that, I encourage you to watch this video that I made. It's called Global Warming Mashup. The video has been banned in some countries by YouTube. In this video, if you watch it, you'll see that, according to NASA, carbon dioxide is not the most powerful greenhouse gas. In fact, water is. Water is the most powerful greenhouse gas. What could we possibly do to control the water? It's time to wake up and realize that God is real, that God does control the weather. He always has controlled it. We people have been ignoring God, and God has likewise ignored us. But at some point, the game is over. If you believe in God and you believe in Jesus, and you ever see a storm coming your way, I strongly suggest that you pray and ask for protection in the name of Jesus. There's a lot of power in the name of Jesus. If you think that Jesus could be real, but you're not sure, and you want to be saved, then I strongly suggest that you just pray right now to God. Ask Him to forgive you. Just pray and say, Heavenly Father, I'm sorry for the sins that I've done. Please forgive me. And please, Jesus, come into my heart and save me. If you pray that right now, and you say it sincerely, you will be saved. Peace to everyone.